In the previous video, I've shown you how to enable ADB and DevTools on a user.add.tim file to make your phone acting as a normal KaiOS or Firefox OS device. However, if all you want is just to install OmniSD or any other application directly, bypassing the previous guide, here is the solution. The procedure seems to be very simple at first glance, but in reality it requires a lot of attention, as we will practically take the place of a direct installation, as the settings need to be precise. Before starting, I recommend you to take a look at the main guide on the universal method, because it's important to know how to get an user.add.tim file and how to use the EDL tools. Requirements: 1. Download the omnij4datapatch.zip file that I've prepared for you. 2. Install DB browser for SQLite, needed to write a special file for the permissions. 3. Obviously your PC. 4. Patience. Lots of patience. Jio Phone users can find ready-made user.add.tim files on the internet. This procedure can also be used to add other applications other than OmniSD. Proceedings: 1. Extract omnij4datapatch.zip and put the omnis.83137.ziz folder in /data/local/webapps. 2. Edit the webapps.json file and add the content of the decl.patch file, checking that the format is valid, for example using the website jsonlint.com. 3. Use DB browser for SQLite to change the permissions in /data/local/permissions.sqlite with the right permissions. 4. In the tab Browse Data, select /mos_perms. As you can see, there are several lines that represent the permissions of the apps themselves. This file is a starting point if you need to check the permissions on your app. Now pay attention to the next step. 5. You have to add 5 lines. A trick is to create them directly, as in the example, and the only columns that get different values from are type and modification time. In order: first column, origin, we must write /omnis.83137.zizappid equals localhead for all the lines. Replace localhead with a value following the previous application and do the same in webapps.json. In this example, the number is 1048. Second column, type, we must be sure to enter the correct parameters. For OmniSD index, device storage apps read, device storage card read, web apps manage and power. Every name says what is the related function of the app. Third column, permission, enable the permissions by adding 1. Fourth and fifth columns, expire type and expire time, enter the number 0 for both. Sixth column, modification time, set an increasing time, even a few digits, as in the example. Jio Phone users can bypass the OmniSD restrictions in this way, for example by reading the permissions in Jio Store. Warning: make sure that localhead in webapps.json and localhead in origin match, and also install time and update time must match precisely the first and last lines. This applies to any application you are going to install manually. 6. Save the file and flash the user.a.timd file. Now the app is working with the right permissions. Even if some updates preventing the app to work as it should. Reflash the data partition using your correct firewalls and EDL tools. For the rest of the video, I will check if all the modifications are okay. Our custom data partition is ready to make the app sideload. The developer menu is still hidden, then you have to perform a privileged factory reset. This guide took OmniSD as an example, but you can also install Wallace or Wallace Toolbox for this in the same way. FTPD and debug can also be useful for inserting the necessary files, such as the public key that I mentioned in the guide to enable the development tools. Thanks for your attention and support. See you next. BananaHackers.net. Join the revolution.